case on the agenda tonight are Hahira cases, is that right, Matt?
Yes, sir.
So please, go ahead, proceed.
All right, these two items from the city of Hahira are the same applicant for the same property, two different requests. First one is a special exception, request for land use within the Hahira Gateway Corridor Overlay District. The second one is variances to that same provision of the Hahira zoning ordinance as they apply to the overlay district. I think for purposes of discussion and maybe even public hearing, we can consider the two together in terms of our review and discussion of them. But when it comes time to make motion and vote, we need to vote on them separately. And I would recommend keeping the order as they are in the agenda, special exception first, and then the variances. Special exception request is for a gasoline station that has more than 8 pumps. Subject property is 2.64 acres, zoned highway commercial. This is in the Gateway Corridor Overlay District, kind of in the middle. But as you see, it's along Georgia Highway 122 West. It is directly across from the new Lowndes, which was an out parcel off to the side of the Food Lion grocery store shopping center. A lot of land around it is vacant. But the maps on the screen show the zoning pattern, which is dominated by CH. You also have a map of the overlay district itself, which is the cross-hatched area that is shown. The overlay district extends from the railroad crossing on West Main Street near downtown all the way westward to the far side of exit 29, all the way to Knights Creek. Aerial imagery shows the abundance of vacant land to the north, as well as the subject property itself, which is still forested, although they've done some clearing of the underbrush. To the south, you see the rooftops of the Lowndes and the Huddle House and the grocery store. Immediately to the west is a dental clinic, and I think it's a Napa store at the corner of Union Road. What you're seeing also in terms of roadway design is finally the finished product of Exit 29 rebuild that took many, many years to complete, which part of that was a realignment of Union Road, which is that intersection you see there on the left side. Subject property, again, the trees are in place, but a lot of the underbrush is gone. This is looking eastward, back toward the center of town. Subject property is there on the immediate left. Adjacent properties include the dental clinic to the west and the Hahira Vet Clinic, which is further to the east. There's a wetlands area in between. Then the Huddle House and the Lowndes that are across the street. In your packet also is a survey. You see some irregular shape to it. We'll get to that in a moment. But that's the boundaries of the 2.64 acres. You see some of the wetlands that are denoted. The applicant's engineer, I think they've got a wetlands mitigation plan of some kind in the works. All that gets reviewed during the city's development process. Site plan in your packet shows the proposed building, which is a convenience store with a Bojangles restaurant and drive-thru. And then a detached fuel canopy island out front with 8 islands, twin pumps on, or pumps on either side. There's a little discrepancy in definitions, but it could accommodate up to 16 vehicles at one time, the way they've got it drawn. One of the interesting features, which is a trigger for some of the variances, is you see the front yard has a what looks like a frontage road driveway running parallel to 122. Where it loops back in and ties in directly across from the entrance to the commercial center that's across the street. Georgia DOT is requiring them to line up the driveways this way, because it's a median crossing, but it's an intersection there. And it just creates a little bit of a burden, I think, on the applicant to extend that. But we'll get to that detail when we get into the variances. Also in your packet is a floor plan. You see most of the building, which is about 6,700 square feet. About two-thirds of that is convenience store, the rest of it is restaurant. Building elevations, as you know, the Overlay District in Hahira has architectural standards, just like the Overlay District in BoValdosta. The building they're showing is compliant with the architectural requirements in terms of the features and ornamentation and so forth. I tried to find an example of another gasoline convenience store where it's a detached fuel canopy. This is one that actually is a picture I took for the Valdosta case on your agenda. This is the raceway at exit 18, and it shows a detached canopy in front. This one's a little bit larger. It has five double islands going across the front instead of two, so it's got a few more pumps. A very similar size building. Applicants proposing 6,700 square feet. This building you see is about 8,000 square feet, but also sits further back from the road than what the applicant is proposing. So this one's just a little bit bigger, but a little different configuration than what you're seeing. At least gives you an idea of the magnitude of what's been proposed. So in your packet is, of course, all these maps and information. The concern here is simply the use. Like we talked about at the work session, gasoline stations are permitted use in CH. They are also a permitted use in the overlay district as long as it does not go above 8 pumps. Above 8 pumps triggers the special exception review. So they're proposing more than 8, and that is why it's going through this particular application process. If it were 8 or less, there would be no need for a special exception. The gasoline station in this case is part of a multi-use facility. Gas station pumps with the main store with a drive-through restaurant. So that's the special exception. The variances, which is the next agenda item, for same use, same property, but it boils down to three, which on your cover page I've listed as A, B, and C. The first variance is that of minimum building setback. The overlay district requires a minimum of 15 feet setback from Georgia 122 and a maximum setback of 75. Which means at least 50% of the front wall of the building should be within that setback area. Gasoline canopy does not meet the definition of building. Like we talked about at the work session, if it were attached to the building, we would consider it like a front porch and therefore included in how we review setbacks. The gasoline canopy of what they're proposing is within that 15 to 75 foot setback area. So if it were attached, there would be no variance to this requirement, but because it's detached, it stands on its own as an accessory structure, and then we measure setback distance to the convenience store or restaurant itself, which in this case, they're proposing 165 feet instead of the 75-foot maximum. So there's a little bit of gray area in semantics in the mathematics, but that's how they're doing it. Some of these kinds of facilities, at least around Valdosta, some of them are detached, some of them are attached. I know just from personal experience, if it's raining, I'm going to prefer the one that's attached. So that's the first variance. The second one is the 50% rule for the front yard, is what we call it, where it stipulates that no more than 50% of your front yard area, which is between the building and the street, can be pavement, such as driveways or parking lots. In this case, the applicant is greatly encumbered by what Georgia DOT is imposing on them. They're a little bit above the 50% rule, they're at 64%. But as you can see on this drawing, a lot of that area, which we have to measure the entire front yard all the way across, a lot of that is driveway that's being imposed on them by Georgia DOT so that they can line up with another intersection. If that were not the case, they would comply with the 50% rule. So that's the second. The third one is the 5-foot sidewalk requirement along Georgia 122. We have had several variance requests to this one in the past, at least for properties in this area. This section of 122 does not have existing sidewalks in it, unlike West Main Street as you get closer into downtown. There is a plan that is a joint project between the City of Hahira and Georgia DOT to do streetscape improvements along this segment of 122. So what the applicant is proposing is simply to take their internal walkways, extend them out to Georgia 122, and would eventually tie in to whatever DOT and the city come up with for the road itself. So they would stub out to it. It would be sort of silly for them to install sidewalks on their own, simply to have it redone by this property. So same argument and ruling as we've done with other variances. So as you see with the request, starting in backwards order, with the variance, staff is recommending approval of all three of them, finding all three of them compliant with the variance review criteria. Those details are there in your packet. However, with the special exception review, we are recommending denial based on the magnitude of the proposed use and its location within the district. We see a difference between the part of the overlay district that's closer to downtown versus that of interchange. This is in the intermediate area in staff's view. But the size of the fueling station and all the traffic and everything that comes with that, just a little too intensive. We think it's more appropriate for this size facility to be at the interchange itself, or at least on the other side of it. So if with the special exception, we're recommending denial. Variances, we're recommending approval. The applicants are here. We're glad to answer any questions you may have.
So Matt, essentially, by denying the special exception, you're limiting to limit them to four items, so to speak, just using the
eight pumps, however they want to configure.
So normally, in my experience, you have an island where you go fill up your car with gas or truck, and on each side there's a fueling station.
Correct. So designated by pump numbers and so on.
So without approval of the special exception, they can basically only have four islands, for example, with two on each side.
Correct.
Would you say this property, if there is such a thing as a norm, is 2.6 acres? Is that like a normal size for this type of gas station in this area, as far as the amount of land they put it on? Or
well, in this area, there's few examples really to go by.
Well, I mean, not just Hahira, maybe the entire Lowndes County area.
I mean, there's some that are larger, some that are smaller. I mean, the raceway that I showed you a picture of, I think, is on the larger side. I mean, there's a racetrack that's part of the truck stop that's being built. There's a quick trip that's across the street from it. I think that's one of four pumps. So it's more than the 16.
Okay.
But if you look at some of the others along Hill Avenue and Ashley Street, they're configured differently, but different amount of pumps. In terms of the acreage, I think the site plan speaks for itself. What they're actually using for the uses is less than 2.64 acres. I mean, they've got a little bit of real estate tied up in the driveway that's extra. So, I mean, definitely 2 acres or more. Parking, they're trying to meet all the parking requirements and get everything to fit. I think it's pretty darn close. One of the issues, you know, we had discussed with them that they've made some provisions for is to put in potential connection easements for other properties as things may redevelop. One of the concerns we've got is what they're showing is one driveway entrance off of 122 for what I think is going to become a busy site. As things develop and redevelop long term, I think interparcel access, which is a requirement of the overlay district, is important, and it's going to become real important here, I think, particularly when the properties to the west redevelop eventually. So they're at the corner. But what they're doing is, since they don't have the crystal ball, they're showing easements for possible connection. The cost in the, of actually doing all of that will fall on whoever does the redevelopment. So they're simply allowing connection for a future discussion, whether it's property to the west or, in this case, I think even property to the north, which is still vacant. They are showing the connection stub out on property to the east, which is currently vacant, but is wetlands. So there's even more unknowns on that part of it.
Thank you. Those are the only questions I had. Any commissioners, any other questions for Mr. Martin on this? So you'd like us to go ahead and act on this?
Yeah, do the vote separately. There are two separate requests, and at least for staff, it's two different recommendations. But we've got public hearing to get through first.
Okay. No, commissioners, no questions for Mr. Martin? Okay, with that said, is there anyone here this evening who would like to speak in favor of this case? Please come forward.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. My name is Brad Folsom, 2611 North Patterson. I'm an attorney here in town. And I offer my apologies, Mr. Cattell, for my dear 45-day trip back to India. It's been scheduled for about a year and a half, so he comes back in a couple of days. But I wanted to introduce him in this way. You know, Mr. Cattell owns both of those angles here in town, 84 and the one on the inner perimeter of Venus. He also owns one in Tifton. He's developing one in Altry. He's having a core deal in North Florida, which he sold. But I think what you would find with all of his properties and the way he does business is they are extremely clean, they are extremely well landscaped. I think if you visited any of his properties, you would see that. He does a 100% job of keeping them in that condition. He is also very different from typical owners, I think very involved in the community. He's involved in both school systems. He does various things like that. So I think from a fit standpoint, the type of development he wants to do is much different than the raceway that we show or any of these other gas stations. You know, for instance, he has been looking for operators and has turned down a couple for two reasons. One, both of them wanted larger facilities than the eight he has. And also, he does not want any of his operators. He wants this to be sort of, in his words, a family-type operation. So he's not going to have the gaming machines inside. He's not going to have CBD products. All the things that might bring a different sort of element to his location. I would say also about the development of the area. You know, this area is starting to develop. I mean, the new interchange has been built. Significant street improvements on 122 through this area. Businesses across the street, the Wendy's Huddle House, I think there's going to be a coffee shop at the other corner of the grocery store. The entire area north of his that he's bought a part of, has already been approved for development, you know, in a general way. There's no specific plans, but they are working to develop that entire area sort of from a retail type standpoint. So I think you're going to see a lot here. Matt made a comment that this needs to be closer to the interstate. Well, you can see the interchange from the standing front. It's literally 300-400 yards from the exit and entry ramps. And there is no other land around the interchange that can be developed of this type. So this is the closest thing to the interstate that can be developed in Hahira. You know, this property and this development will be, I think, significant boon for the city of Hahira in terms of investment, tax dollars, drawing people off the interstate. For other businesses, all of those things. And the way Mr. Cattell runs his businesses, I think will fit right into the community in terms of that type of thing. I want to address the one issue and the special exception. And we did not even think there would be an issue when we brought this. And this was kind of out of left field when we had the pre-meeting with Matt and his staff as far as the difference between or the word pump. In there, we believed eight because we had done our research in terms of what the gas industry considers a pump. And what it considers a dispenser. I provided just one of what you literally Google in 5 minutes, hundreds of articles that say the exact same thing that I provided you all tonight. You know, the old way was to have a pump at that island you pull up to and two cars can pull up to. Well, now that's not a pump. The pump is actually in the tank. If you talk to any developer of gas and diesel products or any jobber or anybody else, the pumps are in the tank. Those things on each side of the island, no matter what anybody thinks about them, are dispensers. And because the language of the statute wasn't really given a thought, probably, when it was developed, because there's no definition of pump in the overlay district ordinance. So there's been no thought given until now. And I think it's very unfair to an applicant that believes and understands from a general belief out there in the public, this is what a pump means, this is what a pump is. And then all of a sudden, the government tells them, no, we meant something different 20 years ago, but we didn't define it. I think that's extremely unfair once somebody's done their homework and tried to do a development. That's going to be a good development for the community. So I would very much advocate that you approve the special exception over the suggested of staff and also approve the variances. And Mr. Bill Kent's here, the engineer on the project, to answer any technical questions about any of the layout or anything like that. And we've given you a copy of the slide. It's I think will fit right into it.
Thank you, Mr. Wilson.
Yes, sir.
We still have some time if there's anyone else here who would like to speak, or did you plan to speak, sir? Or
no, unless you have a question.
Oh, sorry, of course.
Commissioners, any questions for this gentleman? Thank you. All right. Is there anyone here this evening?
I'm sorry. Mr. Folsom, could you come back? I'm sorry, Mr. Chairman. Could you address the rumor that we have heard that there was some intention to put a truck stop on the backside of this property? Obviously, on this particular lot, there's no room for that.
I don't think that's something that the people who own the property want. I know it's something Mr. Patel has no intention to do. He has never thought in terms of truck stop.
Okay.
Actually said I don't want the burden of that kind of active, so I don't think there's any idea to do that.
Okay, thank you for addressing that.
Yes, ma'am. All right, is there anyone here this evening that would like to speak against this case? Anyone here that would like to speak against this case? No one appearing? So, I will now call for a motion if there is one.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, ma'am.
I make a motion that agenda item, we're, I think, voting on number three first.
We're voting on special exception.
For the special exception. I make a motion that we approve this for special exception request HA-2023-01.
So we have a motion to approve by Commissioner Roundtree. Is there a second? And we have a second by Commissioner Wiles to approve the special exception. All those in favor, raise your hand of the motion. Oh, I can't vote.
You're just modeling.
I'll get used to it.
Right.
All those opposed? Any opposed? You're opposed?
Point of clarification, please.
Yes, ma'am.
This is a motion to recommend approval.
Recommend approval.
Yes.
This is a motion to approve the special exception.
Recommend
approval. Recommend approval. And I think it was unanimous, Mark.
Yes, sir.